I'm here with Jaclyn Konzelmann. She's Director of Product Management for Google Labs here at Google I.O. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
So Google Labs, this is the part of Google that deals with really the cutting edge. It's experimenting with things before it reaches the everyday consumer. Talk to us about what was announced today that excited you the most.
Oh boy, there were so many exciting announcements. I think that throughout all of them, personally, I mean, Project Mariner, obviously, because I've had a firsthand experience in shaping that. But beyond that, a lot of the generative media stuff that was announced today is really exciting to me. New VO models, and then even the Gemini diffusion model, I think is just a really interesting new type of model that we're launching right now to the world.
Talk to us more about Project Mariner.
Absolutely. So Project Mariner is a research prototype that's exploring the future of human-agent interaction, starting with browsers. And what we launched today was a web app that allows anybody to give Project Mariner a task, and it will be able to go and navigate across the internet to complete it. And the specific version that we launched today can also handle up to 10 tasks that it can do at the same time, allowing people to really try to multitask.
Agents are really kind of the next frontier of AI. We talk a lot about how artificial intelligence can boost productivity, and agents seem to be really at the forefront of that. But I'm curious about how this moves from the innovation lab to prime time, especially because if you're asking an AI to do something, you really want to make sure it gets it right.
Absolutely. So I think that that's part of the power of launching Project Mariner as this research prototype as an experiment right now. We are putting users at the forefront of being able to try this out firsthand. We are pairing nicely the ability for Project Mariner to multitask, but also a user at any time can watch everything that it's doing. It'll get a live view of the task as it's happening, and a user can take over the task at any time. They can also pause the agent from doing the task and resume it at a later point in time, or they could choose to trust Project Mariner if they're giving it something that's, you know, a simpler task and go back to whatever it is that they're doing. So we've really tried to blend user control with pushing forward what these agents are capable of, and launching it as that early experiment kind of lets us take it to that next phase of bringing it to people.
So is this kind of like Google's answer for OpenAI's operator?
You know, taking a step back, I think that the environment of agents is something that is just starting to really bloom. And this is, as you said, kind of the year of the agents. So Project Mariner is our offering right now that really focuses on how do we let people try out what it would mean to give an agent a task. And so what we launched today is available to anybody in the US as part of our Google AI plan. So we're really excited to bring that into people's hands.
Talk to us about what kind of feedback you're getting from users so far, because this has kind of been tinkering in the background for a little bit.
Absolutely. So we initially launched Project Mariner back in December as a Chrome extension that you would install. And the agent would actually take control of your browser, which was really cool to watch. But some of the early feedback that we got from those trusted testers was after that kind of cool factor wore off, they really wanted to be able to take control of the browser and do whatever it was they were doing while having Project Mariner continue on the task. So one of the things that we focused on with this latest version was having agents that could run these tasks in the background. Another key piece of feedback that we got was users loved being able to take control of the browser from Project Mariner, but they really wanted to be clear if Mariner was operating on the browser or if they were operating on the browser. So we've made it much more explicit for people to say if they want to take over the task or over the browser and then hand it back to Project Mariner if they want the agent to continue resuming. So I think those are two kind of key areas where the trusted tester feedback really helped shape what this next version of Project Mariner became.
Talk to us about what you're expecting from the actual users in terms of what they look like, how old they are, what their backgrounds typically look like. Who gravitates toward agentic technology more than others?
You know, I think in the current stage it's at, once again, being a research prototype, kind of at the cutting edge and the forefront of AI and agents right now, we're really seeing people that want to experience the cutting edge technology from Google, the AI enthusiasts, if you will, the people that want to see what's possible, what's capable, and have an understanding of how that can shape where these products and features and experiences are going.
Like the power users.
Exactly, exactly. And then as these capabilities become a little bit more hardened and we figure out exactly, you know, how to bring them into products, of which they will continue to be brought out into all of the Google products, that will start to cater to the different users that those different products tend to attract.
When it is more broadly available, what is it going to cost users?
You know, I can't speculate on that one. I think it will likely depend on the different products that it makes its way into. You already heard earlier today advancements in search with AI mode, with the Gemini app. So I think you're going to see these capabilities come out in a variety of different products and in a variety of different shapes. And the way they roll out will vary based on what those products are.